Earlier this year, myself and Jason Malinson were invited to come and work with Spain's Guardia Seville cave rescue and recovery team. This particular cave had about a 30-foot ladder we had to climb down, and then we got into the cave portion and had quite a bit of caving to do to get to the water. This is a very difficult process, wearing all of your equipment, including a very hot dry suit. A bit heavy and awkward when you're not just floating along. Comes one of the team members now. They've been ferrying our other equipment down.
No, come on. Nope, I have lights. No problem. I need my big butt.
You just get up to your rope, going straight.
Okay. Excellent.
A simple slip and fall here would be very difficult to get out of. Look, there's one of my tanks. Now to get in that nice, cool water. one of the local cave divers is going to show us around and lead us to a big air chamber. He is the one out front in the yellow helmet on open circuit. The red helmet here is Jason. He is on a KISS Sidewinder also. Just look at all these incredible formations. Everywhere. Floor here, you see what was once crystal pools. At once, the water level in here created these pools of water which formed crystals. we will start seeing a difference in the water. The bluer, clearer water is salt water. The fresher water and the salt water meet. You get this oily film that you can't see well. So apparently our guide took us down the wrong tunnel. So as they backtrack, Jason and I went off exploring. These are helictites. They are a strange cave formation. Some of these formations are so fragile, you don't want to even look at them. Crystal pools are fantastic. This is an area that even when the cave was dry, was permanent pools of water. And so crystal structures formed up to the level of that water. Sometimes the crystals grew all across the surface of the water, leaving a cavity down below.
Just crazy, isn't it?
Yeah.
I'm kind of glad we got lost because this is better than hiking.
Yeah.
With all of our gear on.
It continues, it's like just, you have to just follow it along and just
exploring.
Yeah, I'm happy doing that.
There's a continuation of the line here. And then right at the start, there was another line going up, wasn't there? You know, when we went down from the lake at the start, there was another red line going up there as well.
So he just got on the wrong line, huh?
He doesn't know this cave at all. I think he just...
This thing's massive.
To a cluster of lines that are not marked properly. If we don't mark which line we came in on, we will not know how to exit. Dive, all of the equipment has to be carried back out. Stay tuned for the next part.